Good.
All right, well, thanks everybody. My name's Rob Gibson, I'm with TGS. Just three slides to show you. What we're pitching is the concept of predicted well log curves based on existing curve response, given the high density that we've got in the unconventionals in particular. So what we did is we started with the Permian Basin, where you've got a lot of wells with just a single curve, usually a gamma ray, a whole bunch more that have got two curves, three, and then your typical quad combo or five curve suite. This ended up being our training data for this. It's about 42,000 wells. We have quad combo or a five curve suite. The curves are resistivity, neutron, density, gamma ray, and sonic. And as a seismic company, we're really interested in the sonic. There's not a lot of sonic data run in the Permian over the areas that we were interested in shooting seismic. So we really wanted to see if we could use this information to predict what the sonic would look like, especially over our seismic areas. 85% of the wells are missing sonics over at least a portion, if not the entire interval. So what we did is we took all the wells in the Permian, predicted what the, or looked at what the sonic response was by itself, and then looked at what we could do to get a sonic prediction out of that. So what we did is we took this cross-section from the southwest to the northeast and plotted all the sonic data that exists in our existing inventory, and then used a machine learning algorithm, gradient boosted algorithm, to be able to predict and see if we could infill what this picture might look like to help augment our seismic data. And from this, we were able to get to this, just using the well logs in a two-dimensional space. And you could, of course, move the slice just like you can through any seismic data and take a look at what the data would look like in three dimensions as well. So again, moving from this to this. And we did this for all five of the curves, but this was the one we were most interested in. Just one more example, same cross-section line using, looking at density. And again, you can go from a rather coarse density to a rather dense set of density in that area. We are looking at correlating this to our existing seismic coverage, our basin temperature models, TOC cubes, and some other things. We're very positive on the results as far as giving you a high-level picture of what's going on in an area. I wouldn't say that if you're trying to increase production of a single wellbore, this is probably not the right data set. You need recorded data sets, much more in lines with this.
Time is up.
Okay, thank you very much.